Now, as we have studied in the previous lecture, that modern definition of log associates logarithms with exponential functions. So what we'll study now is how to take anti-log of a given logarithm. Say for example, if I'm given some log, and which is log x to the base a, and this is equal to some number n, then what I know is by definition, n is the exponent of a that is equal to x. So I can simply write it as x is equal to a to the power n, and this operation is called as inverse operation of log, and we also call it as anti-log. Now say for example, suppose I am given log x base 2 equals 5. I can take this 2 on the right hand side and I can write this x as 2 to the power 5, which is 32. I'll take another example, which is log x base 5 is equal to minus 2, then x is 5 to the power minus 2, which is 1 upon 25. So when I remove log, so if I need to remove log, I need to use anti-log. Now there are many questions which are based on anti-log. I'll take up a simple example. Say for example, now suppose the question is solve for x, log x square minus 12x plus 36 to the base 10, and this is equal to 2. So what I know is I can remove log by taking anti-log. I can write it as x square minus 12x plus 36, and this is 10 to the power 2. So I'll write it as x square minus 12x. Now 100 minus 36 is minus 64, and this is x minus 16. X plus 4 equals to 0. So that is the value of x is either 16 or the value of x is minus 4. So answer to this question is the value of x is 16 or minus 4. I'll take up another question. Now this question again is solve for x. So what I'll do is I'll take this e, I'll take anti-log. I can write it as log to the base 5, and this is under root of 2x minus 2 plus 3. And this is e to the power 0, which is 1. Now again, I'll take anti-log for this 5. So I can write under root of 2x minus 2 plus 3. And this is 5. So under root of 2x minus 2 is equal to 2. Now if I square, I'll write 2x minus 2 is equal to 4. So which is x is equal to 3. So answer to this question will be the value of x should be equals to 3. Now another question is again solve for x, which is 1 by 12 log x base 10 whole square is equal to 1 by 3 minus 1 by 4 log x base 10. So what I know is this equation is actually a quadratic equation in log x to the base 10. So what I'll do is I'll let log x to the base 10 as some y, and I can rewrite it as y square upon 12 1 by 3 minus 1 by 4y, I can take LCM, so y square upon 12, and this is 4 minus 3y upon 12, so which is y square plus 3y minus 4 equals to 0, and I'll write it as y plus 4, y minus 1 equals to 0, so value of y is either minus 4 or value of y is 1. Now I need to find value of x, so what I'll do is, I'll substitute the value of y, so y is log x base 10, and this is minus 1, so in this case it'll be x is equal to 10 to the power minus 4 or log x base 10 is equal to 1, and if I take anti-log again I can get this x as 10. So value of x is either 10 to the power minus 4 or the value of x is 10. Now the question is find the domain of this function, which is expressed as log base 7, log base 5, log base 3, log base 2, and 2x cube plus 5x square minus 14x. Now there are three restrictions in log. The first condition is x should be greater than 0. So for this outermost log, I'll take this as x, and I can write log to the base 5, base 3, base 2, 2x cube plus 5x square minus 14x should be greater than 0. Now I'll take this anti-log. So I'll write it as log 3 log 2 2x cube plus 5x square minus 14x should be greater than 5 to the power 0, which is 1. Now again, I'll take anti-log for this 3. Log 2, 2x cube plus 5x square minus 14x should be greater than 3 to the power 1, which is 3. Now again, I'll take anti-log. 2x cube plus 5x square minus 14x is greater than 2 to the power 3, which is 8. So I can express this inequality as 2x cube 5x 2x cube plus 5x square minus 14x minus 8 is greater than 0. So now it is a polynomial inequality. Basically, it's a cubic inequality, and we have already studied in previous lectures how to solve polynomial inequalities. Now for a cubic inequality, now the first thing that I need to do is I need to find one value of x using trial and error method. So if I put x as 2, in this case, this expression is 0. So that means one of the factor of this expression is x minus 2. We have also studied synthetic division in previous lectures. So what I'll do is I'll write it as 2. Now the coefficients of x are 2, 5, minus 14, minus 8. So first one is 0, so which is 2, then 4, 9, 18, plus 4, this is 8. So remainder, it must always be 0. So I can write it as x minus 2 into, and this is 2x square plus 9x plus 4, and this should be greater than 0. So I can factorize this quadratic expression as x minus 2, 2x square plus 8x plus x plus 4 should be greater than 0. X minus 2, 2x plus 1, x plus 2, x plus 4 should be greater than 0. So the roots are minus 4, minus 1 by 2 and 2, and this is plus, minus, plus and minus. What I need is plus. So the domain of this function will be x belongs to minus 4 to minus 1 by 2 union 2 to infinite. If you like the video, consider subscribing and sharing it with someone you know who might benefit from it. Also, the best way to navigate any topic is through a playlist. Simply go to the channel page, click playlists, and select the topic you wish to study.